You should hear the terminology they say in these contracts. To use your name and likeness in perpetuity throughout the universe, who the fuck could possibly know what that means? It's so complicated, in fact, that when you're a kid like me, you have to hire somebody to tell you what that means. And you sit down at a table and you do the contract game. And that's how I got with Comedy Central. I signed a contract. I was desperate. I needed a way out. And it wasn't good money and it wasn't good circumstances. But what else am I going to do, I said. And all these white people sitting at that table told me, trust us, Dave, it's a good contract. And I looked around the table and they all seemed to agree it was a good contract. But what if it was like that game of three-card Monty? What if they were all friends and I didn't know it?
In the last video, the curses of the contract, the death clause.
We discussed that all artists, no matter what genre of music, ethnic background, all of them are property of the recording labels.
Since the recording labels own their slaves legally, that means they can do whatever they please regarding their slave in order to make themselves richer.
The label owners
also collect the millions, or should I say billions of dollars, from the insurance policies that was purchased after the recording artist signed the contract.
The label owners can kill and replace the recording artist with a clone or another person wearing masks, bodysuits, and prosthetics. So the new artist, operating under the original artist, image and likeness, which belongs to the recording labels by contract, can now carry out the agendas of the recording label without any resistance. I will give a few examples to show they replace your favorite celebrities.
I said you kid knocker said you ain't no clown.
She ain't no clown. What you mean I'm not no clown or not no clown? Which one? I'm confused like a motherfucker. Not the real Gucci, Jose. Well, goddamn, let somebody go get the real one then, goddamn, I thought I was the real one.
Labels try to clone me, but ain't no way to clone me. Labels try to clone me, but ain't no way to clone me. I brought so many people that my family disown me.
Obviously, ladies and gentlemen, we are looking at two different people, okay? Two different people. Just look at the earlobe, okay? Same side. Teardrop tattoo. I want to see you dance your way out of this one. Why is the ears different? You know why they're different? Because they're two different people.
They've been asking me if the Gucci man that came out of jail, is he a clone? Okay, perhaps they listen to B.O.B. Perhaps they think the world is flat, but they think...
Rapper Hobson was taking credit for being the Gucci imposter. Hobson admits half-truths about the real Gucci Mane being alive somewhere. Hobson also insists that the powers that be needed him to wear the Gucci Mane suit and fool the masses into believing that, 1. The new Gucci is a clone, 2. Or that Gucci lost weight and developed a healthy lifestyle while in prison. They will never admit publicly that celebrities wear masks to play different characters.
They told me to go to this office. It was on Wilshire Boulevard in Los Angeles. And then when I went in, I asked them over the phone, are they going to have me do? They said they couldn't tell me. And then when I went into the office, they sat me down and it was like an all white room. And they opened one of the doors and it had a Gucci suit. A Gucci bodysuit. And I said, oh no. Please don't tell me that is what I think it is. They said, yeah, it's exactly what you think it is, pal. And I said, no, please. Please, no, not the Gucci suit.
Some rappers even put coded messages in their songs.
I get high on my own, sir. Heard you gon' clone, sir. Stop all that flexing. Young nigga don't wanna go there. Heard you gon' clone, sir. Stop all that flexing. Young nigga don't wanna go there. Heard you gon' clone, sir. Young nigga don't wanna go there.
Is is it hard to be fresh if you don't have money, or can you still pull it off?
See, when I ain't had no money, I still had sauce. Mm-hmm. See, if you don't got no sauce, then you're lost.
Mm-hmm.
But you can also get lost in the sauce.
You can get how you get lost in the sauce?
Man, a bitch gonna get lost in the sauce, man.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying?
I know what you're saying, man.
I'm sprinkling sauce, dropping sauce every street, man.
Right.